Yo, my bad. I just did a video just now, and I hit the button, turned off the video. Now this is gonna be part two of the video. So now I'm gonna start where I left off at. So don't get confused, guys. I will put down part one and part two, okay, of the story. Okay, so please bear with me. I'm sorry. Anyway, this is the part where I left off at now. Bayamon is still arguing with the kid. Now, all five kids that, out of all five, remember, Big Man, Sasquatch was by himself, but he recruited four other dudes. So now, they had Bayamon surrounded. The other nietas, the five nietas, was in the kitchen, the day room, fixing up the food. The reason why they started arguing, because nobody goes in the day room when they're fixing the food. Nobody goes in there. You got to have a hat, gloves, wash your mouth and all that stuff, clean yourself up before you touch that food. You feel me, yo? But homeboy wanted to go in the day room and serve his own tray. That's crazy. That's crazy. You can't do that. I don't care. How much power you got. You can't do that, bro. You got other people that eat, too, man. So the next thing you know, Bayamon tells him steps to him now. They arguing, went blah, blah, blah. So the nigga tells Bayamon, yo, man, you know something, man? Fuck you, man. I'm going in the day room. So the dude turns around. So me and Gano get up. This is that shit. I get up. I got my little banger on me. My shit was a nice little skinny little, trust me. Boom, Bayamon got a banger. He got some Rizé. I'm talking about a box. He got a box cutter. Nice fucking one. Nice. I told that nigga to break it half one time to give me half. But he was like, nah, Solo, it's here. It was nice. The whole box cutter, big. Anyway, we go and I tell, yo, big man. Boom, the nigga turns around. And I said, yo, listen, you didn't hear the part when my man said you're not going in the day room, bro? The nigga looked at me and said, yo, this don't concern you. I said, yes, it does concern me. Now, I'm walking towards him. I'm walking towards him. And I said, yes, it does concern me because I eat in this motherfucking dorm. Now, I'm face to face with this nigga. So the nigga like, yo, once again, it's not none, his deep voice. It's not none of your business, he tells me. When he tells me not none of my business, but Yamon swings at this nigga. Boom! I don't know how the fuck this little bastard jumped up and punched this dude in the face. Dude goes like his wobbles a little bit. He it was just a nice punch, but he focused on Bayamon. When he got about to hit Bayamon, that's when I came and caught him. Boom! I came and gave him that nice right. That nice right, son. That this nigga, trust me, his legs got wobbly. Now, Alcano swings at this other dude that was down with the big man. You know what I'm saying? He tells the dude, yo, now you think you gangster now? Boom, he snuffs him. The dude goes down quick. The other dude snuffs Cano. Now the nieta that's in the day room, they running outside. Now they're going to check what's going on and plus the neutrals. Boom. It's me and Big Man now, son. Head up, son. Me and Big Man. Two big motherfuckers, but this nigga's 6'7". I'm 6'2", son. And nigga way bigger than me. Now I'm like, I got to box this nigga, B. So I'm doing my thing. You know what I'm saying? I'm doing my thing. So, but this nigga sees that I got a nice position that I'm doing. He said, this nigga know how to fight. I know. He looked at me and the eye said, this motherfucker knows how to fight. Because the way I was doing, I was dancing. Because I'm moving out the way. I was going to do the move out the way and swing and move out the way. The 1-2 and get out the way. You feeling me? Try to get him dizzy here, So he runs after me. The wall. How you say the wall cry? So when the nigga runs after me, so all I did was went down to the floor like on my knees. Like the TV does? And the nigga flips and he falls face down, B. Boom! His whole front just is fucked up. I'm talking about the nigga came after me so fast, and I did this perfectly that I went down and I tripped him. And he was so big, bro, that the nigga had no time to hit the floor with his hands. So so he hit the floor with the front B. His whole nose B was flat. He could see, you could tell this shit was hanging, bro. The nose bone was hanging. This nigga's leaking. Nigga lost like two teeth. Leaking through the nose, through the mouth. Boom, I get up. Once I get up, I start hitting this nigga again. Bang, bang, bang. The CO grabs me. Yo, Rivera, no, it's enough. Now, when the CO grabs me, this nigga gets up, and the other CO's about to grab him, and he goes and he swings at the CO. He didn't get to hit the CO, but he swings at him. Now, the rest of the dudes that's in the house, they go and they grab this nigga, B. I ain't gonna front. When the CO let me go, I ran there and I gave him a nice one. Boom! One more time. One more time for good luck. You know what I'm saying? Fuck that shit. Now, the other four motherfuckers that was in the house and they were supposed to be chilling, two of them got busy, two of them fell back. But they know what they did. They had to leave. After the SEALs went and told Big Man, yo, pack up, you out of there. Son, I go to my bed and he said, yo, remember, go to your bed. Then when he saw that my bed was right next to him, he said, no, matter of fact, come over here, stay here in the day room. I'm thinking that now these niggas gonna write me up. I'm gonna have to go to the fucking box. And come on, man, you know, this is bullshit, son. So what happens, the motherfucker, they get rid of him, Big Man. He's breaking out. He bangs in the glass. Yo, I'm gonna get you when I see you the hallway. I look at this nigga. I'm like, all right, you know, get my eye, whatever. So, boom, you know, I didn't want to start no more shit. So I liked the house. The house was nice and quiet, man. You know, sometimes you go to a house and you kind of like it because it's quiet. And you don't got to go through a lot of shit, man. You feeling me? So she'll call me. Yo, come over here. I go up to him and say, yo, I'm not going to get you out the house, man, because I see you a parole violator. And you're getting ready to go upstate. That's what you're waiting for your bride. And I said, yeah, that's what I'm waiting for. And after that, I'm out of here. I'm out of your head. So he said, but remember, I know you're ready. You've been coming in and out for your parole violations. You was over here last year. I was in the same house. And the year before that, you was downstairs at Palmer's house. Yes, I was. You know what I'm saying? Yes, I was. So it's like I said, four parole violations back to back to back. So the CEO said, I never heard anything about you. Everything was fair about you. I know you Latin King. I threw it out there. But it's okay. You know what I'm saying? So I rocked. I stood rocking in that house for a minute. So I was there for, like I said, a month and a half. I could have took over the house if I wanted to. But no, I didn't. Nah, it's not my thing. But it's not my fucking thing. My thing used to be take over the house. You know what I'm saying? If not take over the house, if the dude that's running the house, because my man, I'm his man. I'm loyal. But if homeboy got to leave the house, somebody got to take over the house. So a lot of wolves wake up and like, okay, yo, not you, Poppy, me. Nah, not you. And that's how a lot of shit starts. You feeling me, yo? You know, this story is about the last time I had a fight, man. And I'm going to keep it real. I don't even think it was a fight because Big Man hurt his own self. I'm serious. Big Man hurt his own self. Oh, the day after that, one of the guys that was in the house saw Big Man in the bullpen. He was going to court. He said that Big Man had all this shit covered, bro. Like, nigga was like in a car wreck. He said, oh, this right here was swollen. His eyes were swollen. Everything. Like, it was a car wreck. Remember, rikers on the floors are hard, B. Those shits are fucking hard. And one more thing. Maybe if it was lunchtime or dinner time, I would have never said nothing to Big Man. But this is breakfast. This is the only time that you could wake up in the morning and eat some cornflake. Because I used to get two boxes or three. My weight was already up. And then when that shit happened with Big Man, they gave me an extra box. So that was like three boxes and a nice plate of jelly. Nice plate of jelly. And whatever that was given, three milks, two milks. I just take two milks because, you know, I didn't want to seem too greedy. But sometimes you take the third milk to give to somebody else, you know, by a phone call. But like I said, these are some of the shit that you guys out there got to worry about, especially your new guys. Especially your new guys. Some houses you might go to, and they might ban you from eating breakfast. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Dudes be like, yo, don't Don't come out your bed. Breakfast only for certain amounts of people, and that's it. Now give me 15 people, that's it. I'm serious, bro. I've been to houses like that. I've been to a house like that be one time, and I said, nah, not in my fucking, nah. And then what I did was I destroyed the house because it's, yo, everybody's going to leave. Not only me, everybody. And it's going to have a new captain in that house, and the fucking shit's going to stop. I swear to God, man, I went to a house like that, B. And when I'm going in, the nigga say, yo, breakfast is over, and I'm seeing he got the whole shit. You crazy, it ain't over for me, Poppy. I say, I want to trade right now. I want to trade right now, bro. Not now, right fucking now, B. And niggas, give me my fucking trade, because niggas know. Niggas know who's what, what's what, son. Trust me. And once again, I love my breakfast. I'm about to roll this up, you feeling me? I love my breakfast, so ain't nobody going to turn me down on my breakfast. Yo, listen, a couple of days ago, I was talking about famous people who been kicked out of clubs, who are kicked out of clubs. There's some other names that I got to mention. One, Johnny Depp. There was this lounge named the Paris, a lounge. That's a lounge that you can sit down, you can dance a little bit. But it's mostly sitting down and drinking. Then he got so fucked up, that the nigga took his dick out and started pissing in the fucking bar. Right in front of the bar, B. I had to throw him out. Throw him out quickly. You understand what I'm saying? This bitch, she was looking nasty. Britney Spears, when she was going a little crazy, she was making out one of her security guards, this black fat dude. She's making out with this nigga. This club name was Tangier. That was the club that Derek Jeter, Giambi, and two other baseball players was at. That's the day that they left Giambi by himself, and two white girls was about to rob this nigga for everything he had. This nigga was in the VIP by himself. Nobody was there, just them three. When I got this, son, they had this nigga's wallet out of his pocket. Ready to pull a knot like this he had, bro. And I got there and I stopped it, no question. You know, Solo gotta be real. And I stopped that shit, son. And you know what that nigga did? I walked him outside. It's raining, it's pouring. I stopped the cab for that motherfucker. I thought I got soaked. The motherfucker gives me $5. I give it to the cab driver. Still, make sure he gets where we want to go. This is another tip from me to you. $5 fucking, cheap motherfucker. Anyway, yo, this is a story about Rikers Island. Dude trying to Debo breakfast. It's not happening. All right, not a case. Solo's watch. Fuck that. I love my breakfast. I love my Frosted Flakes. I see you guys later. Yo, look for that video about homie talking about Frosted Flakes in jail. Yo, y'all niggas gonna laugh. Trust me. Look for it, all right? And you know I don't say nothing about nobody's channel, but look for that one right there. Yo, this is K-Solo. This is Rikers Island Story, the a.k.a. K-Solo Show. Come on, guys. I need my numbers to start getting bigger again. Come on, I need that little 25,000, all right? A little 25,000. Let's go. I'm gonna bring up this other story tonight. It has to be a offering. So I'm going to offer a story about a rapper. Oh, yes, about a rapper. All right, about a rapper. And this motherfucker is known. So hold your head. Peace. Right, this is how the story. The a.k.a. K-Solo Show. Holla. Oh, one more thing. If you guys want to hear how that I got locked up, how I got locked up and did that 5 to 15, let me know. It's a good fucking story. Very, very interesting story. One of my own people set me up. Check it out. Let me know if you guys want to hear it. I'll bring it. All right? K-Solo. Holla.